I think what really works for a great strategy is to have an understanding of how you're going to plan your creation. So for example, we have this framework called Create, Curate, Collaborate. It gives you a sense of what the brand needs to create, what the brand needs to curate from existing sources or sources that have already some existing content to engage your social media followers, or collaborate with people like influencers or publishers who themselves create content. So what that does is it helps you, it kind of helps a brand kind of plan out what is the content that they need to kind of invest in and plan for it. Another great part of a great content strategy would be an understanding of what the mainline strategy is, because content does not live in a silo. So it needs to always be complementing to the existing campaigns that are happening, maybe in outdoor or maybe print or even on TV. So that would be like a solid content strategy. Content strategy is extremely critical these days because as you can see, when was the last time we clicked on a banner and enjoyed doing it? When was the last time we interacted with a transactional media? All we do is we interact with media that is conversational, that helps us think differently, that inspires us. That's why I think content is really important, because brands need to understand, and I think they are doing that. They're understanding the fact that audiences are moving beyond just transactional media, and there are content creators that are enabling brand to be a part of those conversations. So definitely content creation is going to be, and content amplification is going to be the future. For content, I think some of the great performance indicators would be, what are the number of searches that your brand has created? How many followers your social media page has created? What are the kind of likes that your videos and the other videos have gotten? What is the kind of traffic that has started coming onto your website? It's not so linear as many brands think. It's not about getting the right kind of likes. It's also about the conversations that your boosted post is generating. And definitely, I mean, without mincing words, it needs to drive sales also. So I think it's a mix of hard and soft measures, but also looking at it holistically, because there's not one measure that defines a great KPI. Content marketing can definitely reduce overall marketing costs, because when we've looked at some of the more successful lead generation campaigns, people share their information which they hold very closely to their hearts only when there is a value exchange. So when we've written some amazing white papers, when we've created some amazing infographics, when we've created some great content that is gated, that's when people don't mind sharing their information in exchange for the value that we create. And that is a great way to reduce marketing costs, because you're reducing wastage but providing great value in terms of content.